In the last video, we are studying Fermi Dirac distribution and Fermi level for metal. Now we study semiconductor. What is Fermi level for semiconductor? But before going to Fermi level, first we shall study what is semiconductor. You know semiconductor? Its conductivity is between conductor and insulator. And in terms of energy gap, we have discussed that energy gap is less than 2 electron volt. Now what is energy gap? This is valence band, this is conduction band, the difference between valence band and conduction band. But what is actually we call as a valence band and which electrons? Now conduction band electrons we call free electrons and they are responsible for electricity. So which electron we call conduction band, that we shall discuss. So consider intrinsic semiconductor. For example, silicon. We know silicon is tetravalent. So it forms 4 covalent bonds with neighboring 4 germanium atoms. You can see in this figure. So consider this silicon atom. It forms 4 covalent bonds with these 4 germanium atoms. Okay. So this is the covalent bond. It is formed by sharing of electrons. So these electrons in this covalent bond, please be careful, this is covalent bond. See, these electrons are called as valence band electrons. So these electrons are bound in this covalent bond. So they are not free, they cannot move. So these are not responsible for conductivity. Now high temperature, due to higher energy, this bond is broken. This covalent bond is broken and then this electron, it comes here in this space. This electron is called as conduction band electron. Got it? I will repeat. This is the covalent bond between this silicon atom, this silicon atom. This electron in the covalent bond is called valence band. And when bond is broken, then this electron is not involved in any covalent bonding. It is called free electron and this free electron is called as conduction band electron. Now my question is, what is the energy required to break the covalent bond? Actually, I have already given the answer. This is the electron in valence band. When bond is broken, it becomes conduction band electron. So what is the energy required to break this covalent bond? Okay. I hope you have written the answer. Answer is energy gap. So what is the energy gap? Energy required to excite the electron from valence band to conduction band. Okay. And here we say the electron in covalent bond is valence bond. And when bond is broken, it goes to conduction band. It means that energy required to break this bond is energy gap. Okay. Now we come to Fermi level in semiconductor. Okay. Now we know the definition of Fermi level. It is highest field energy level at absolute zero. But this is definition in metal. We change this definition for semiconductor because in semiconductor, both electrons and holes are responsible for conductivity. Okay. So, when we define Fermi level, we have to consider both electrons and holes. So, how do we define Fermi level? It is center of gravity of electrons in conduction band and holes in valence band. It is center of gravity of electrons in conduction band and holes in valence band weighted according to their energy. So what is center of gravity? In mechanics you know that. Consider this example. Consider this is the mass m1 and this is the mass m2. They are separated by some distance, suppose r. So what is the center of gravity? It is the point where whole mass is supposed to be concentrated. Now consider this is the center of gravity. So what is, how do we find this position? Suppose it is at a distance r1 from m1 and it is r2 from m2. So what is the center of gravity? It is m1 r1 plus m2 r2 upon m1 m2. You know this. I will repeat. M1 r1 plus m2 r2 upon m1 plus m2. So this equation gives the position of center of gravity. Now if m1 is equal to m2, if both masses are equal, we know r1 equal to r2. It means it is at the center of m1 and m2. Now in this case m1 is greater, so the center of gravity is shifted towards m1. So r1 is less than r2. We know that. If m1 equal to m2, it is midpoint. Okay. Now instead of considering the mass m1 and considering the mass m2, we consider the holes in valence band and weighted according to energy. Means we don't consider mass, we consider energy of holes and we consider energy of electrons in conduction band. Okay, so instead of m1 r1 we consider electrons in valence band. R1 means energy, then electrons in conduction band, and R2 means energy from conduction band, and R1 means energy from valence band. Okay, so we have to consider number of electrons in conduction band and number of holes in valence band. Okay, now we are considering intrinsic semiconductor. So when electron from valence band is excited to conduction band, it produces hole in valence band. We know that. When electron from valence band is excited to conduction band, it gives hole in valence band. Okay. So when one electron is conduction band, it produces one hole in valence band. So can we say number of electrons in conduction band is equal to number of holes in valence band? When electrons are excited from valence band to conduction band, there is hole created in valence band. So number of electrons in conduction band is equal to number of holes in valence band. So what would be the position of Fermi level? Just guess. You consider this case. When m1 is equal to m2, when both the masses are equal, we know center of gravity is at the center of m1 m2. Now see the situation. Number of electrons in conduction band is equal to number of holes in valence band. So what would be the position of Fermi level? Yes, correct. It is at the center of energy gap. See, here it is shown. It is at the center of energy gap. Or it is midpoint between valence band and conduction band. Or center, exactly the center between valence band and conduction band. Okay. So this is the position of Fermi level in intrinsic semiconductor. This is by definition. In the next video, we will derive the equation for Fermi level in intrinsic. Now we know that if position, it is at the center of energy gap. Now we will derive that equation. Mathematical study, we will do that in the next video. Okay. Thank you.